This is part two of the psychology of trucking, old school versus new breed, and where we discuss the psychological effects on trucking. And I'm here to tell you there's really no difference between old school and new breed when you break things down, because I know drivers out here that haven't been out here for but a year, but I mean, to sit and talk to them for 15, 20 minutes, you would think they were part of the old school bunch, because they carry on about themselves like the old school. But we're going to talk about the new breed in this one. The new breed is not so much the fault of the driver. They led to it, yes, but it's the carriers that have brought about this new breed of drivers, and I'm going to try to explain this to you. Over the years in this industry, all we've heard about is truck driver shortage this, truck driver shortage that, and we all know the issues behind the truck driver shortages, but I'm not here to debate those. And I'm trying to explain to you what we've done to compensate for that shortage, and that is to cater to drivers. Well, naturally, the mega carriers are not going to be raising pay to attract drivers. God forbid they do something like that. But they start giving these little short runs, these little short regional runs to allow a driver to be in to the house every day, every night, every weekend, because that's what the drivers want. That's what they're the type of driver they're having to attract. There's no problem with that. I mean, when I run long haul, I actually had figured out a lane with my company when I was a company driver. They run 7 loads a week dedicated to one from one terminal to the other terminal. And I asked them why I couldn't have that, because I could do that turn every week. It would make a fair sum of money. It's suitable for me. But they were like, no, we can't do that because we have to spread those loads out with other drivers. Now let's fast forward to today, where the mega carriers have figured out they can short run a driver and make an enormous amount of money. Oh, you're going to tie our truck up for a day? You're going to pay a premium for it, but we're not going to pass that premium on to the driver. But we can let that driver know that we can get him home every day or every weekend, and we make money and he's happy. Now, these new breed drivers don't care that you run 2,500 miles, 3,000 miles, 4,000 miles a week. They don't care. What they want to do is make their money, and they want to be home. And it affects them psychologically to get stuck out. They get cranky. You see it all the time if you talk to dispatchers and companies. They have drivers that just lose it if they're delayed getting home by a day or two. And this is just a fact of life now. And these are the concessions that the companies are having to make in order to attract drivers. They don't really like it neither. They'd really rather have a driver that comes out here, gets in the truck, goes where he's told, stays gone until they tell him he can go home. That's the short and skinny of it. But the new breed driver is one that come out of a 9-to-5 job, and he's come over here because he sees an opportunity to make some money, a lot of money in some cases, but he really doesn't like the job. And a job is what separates the new breed from the old school. The new breed has a job, it's not 9-to-5, but they have a job. Old school has a lifestyle. Many of us are out here because this is something we really enjoy doing, so it doesn't seem like work to us. We're doing something we enjoy. So if you want to put the blame on somebody for the way things are out here right now, you need to put the blame squarely where it belongs, on the carrier. Truck driving can be an extremely stressful job to some people, especially someone who doesn't want to be here. And with the economy opening up, it's going to just get worse out here. So you're going to have to pay attention to what's going on around you with these new drivers out here, because, as I said, many of them don't want to be out here. They don't care. This is just a means to an end for them. And they are taking a lot of chances in extremely dangerous situations. So you want to keep that in mind and keep an eye out for these guys. Now, I'm not here to tell you that every new driver is a new breed, because as I've said, I've met new drivers who have an old school mentality, and my hat's off to those guys. Long story short, you don't know the problems that another driver has, but you can bet those problems are stress related. And with constant stress, we get into the PTSD bunch. And companies aren't addressing this. They don't care. They just want bodies in the seat. If companies cared, they would give you paid time off or pay you enough to begin with that you didn't stay under this kind of stress.